Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Heather Wendler. I am the co-founder and executive director of the Doyenne Group.
Hi, I'm Rachel Neal. I'm one of the organizers for 1 Million Cups Madison.
I'm Amy Gannon, and I'm partner in crime with Heather, co-founder of the Doyenne Group.
So we want to thank you all for coming out this morning. This is our third 5x5x5 event that we've put on so far during Forward Fest, and they're always a lot of fun and a really great fast morning. So I appreciate all of you for coming out. Before we really get started, we want to make sure that we thank our sponsors. So ATC, thank you so much. Sarah, did you want to say anything?
So I'm Sarah Justice with ATC. I'm one of the judges today, so I just wanted to thank everybody for coming. We really appreciate the opportunity to sponsor this event. I think it's fabulous. You know, what we do, we look at how the importance of the electric industry helps the economy and strengthens business here in Wisconsin, and I think that it's very important that we support other parts of the economy, especially developing small business and new entrepreneurs to keep the economy strong in this area. So thank you very much, and welcome to the event.
And then Adam from Align Energy Foundation.
Thank you. Aligned Energy is also very happy to be here and supporting this event. It's my first time here. I haven't experienced it before, but I know this isn't our first time supporting this. We at the Aligned Energy Foundation, are one of our key focus areas is STEM education. And so I think, or I'm excited to hear today, because I think with all these women, you're going to hear different parts of their process and things that they've been through, and you'll see them using science, technology, engineering, and math, and all different ways to make a difference and feature their products. So we are happy to be supporting that area and supporting today's program.
Excellent. Thank you. And then a huge thank you to our event or our space sponsor, the Central Library.
Good morning. My name is Greg Michaels. I'm the library director for Madison Public Library. Welcome to our house. We feel very privileged that we've been able to sponsor events for the Forward Festival. I think it's a fantastic event for this community and for Madison. Over the four events that we've sponsored so far, this will bring us over 100 or 1,000, not 100, over 1,000 attendees here at the library for Forward Festival events. So our vision for the library is your place to learn, share, and create. And this is a terrific example of that. So welcome and thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Greg.
And I'd also like to thank Ed over there in the back corner, who has really been instrumental in helping put this together. And Ed's here every Wednesday with 1 Million Cups, making sure that we have everything that we need and that our presenters are ready to go. So thanks to Ed also.
All right. So we also want to give a huge thank you to Field 59, who is live streaming and recording the event this morning. So feel free, we do have the link up there if you want to tweet it out on social media so everybody can tune in and watch the event this morning. We really couldn't be here without you guys this morning.
And Field 59 is also a regular sponsor of 1 Million Cups on Wednesdays. And if you saw the birthday cake out there, that was for Catherine Garcia. She's usually with Derek behind the camera there. Unfortunately, she was sick today. But please enjoy a slice of cake on her behalf. And we'll wish her well through the live stream.
All right. What's next? Okay, so 5x5x5 is part of the Forward Festival. And if you haven't heard about the Forward Festival, it's been going on. We're in day seven, with one more day to go. So there's been at least 30 events so far, with more events to come between today and tomorrow. And so I wanted to invite Susie Yonko, who's one of the Forward Fest organizers, to come up and speak about it.
Hi, good morning, everyone. Thanks so much for coming out to support the 5x5x5 breakfast. I'm Susie Yonkel from Merlin Mentors. I'm also one of the organizers of Forward Festival. So I would like to say a big thank you to all of our sponsors for Forward Fest. This festival absolutely would not happen without the generous support of these organizations in our Madison community. So thank you to all of them. I also want to mention, so this is day 7 of our 8-day festival, and this is only one of many events today. So we actually, and I want to make sure my numbers are correct here, so we actually have 7 more events coming up today. So including a very interesting Uber pitch, request an Uber this afternoon and get a ride with an investor. Cool jazz with Badger Fun Live, starting Madison, starting block, first impression, art and code. If you like trivia, we have that tonight, and Pachakacha as well. And then tomorrow is the Capital Entrepreneurs Open Social to wrap up the event, and also an event at the Vilas Zoo. So please check those out. ForwardFest.org has all the information about our various events. I'll be here afterwards. Happy to answer any questions about upcoming events. So again, thank you for your support of Forward Festival. This is the 7th year of the festival, and we look forward to more great things next year. And if you want to get involved, talk to any of us about getting involved with organizing next year's event. Thank you.
Thanks, Susie. Thank you.
There we have. Okay, we have a big announcement this morning. And so I'd like to invite Alder Mark Clear to come on up and talk about it.
All right, sat way in the back.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Mark Clear, 10-year member of the Madison City Council, but also a 20-plus year tech entrepreneur. Started a website development company back in 1995 when we had to go around with a laptop and show people what the internet was. I'm not kidding. That's what we had to do then. But I didn't realize we were actually announcing this morning. That's even more exciting. But a couple of years ago, Alder Scott Resnick, who's over there lurking on the side here, former Alder, I should say, sadly, now executive director of Starting Block, and I were talking about entrepreneurship and especially the gender gap in entrepreneurship. And what governments do when they see a problem is they throw money at it. And so we decided to look at ways that the city could invest in entrepreneurship, but especially promote women entrepreneurs. And we put $600,000 in the city budget and decided to take that money, put out a request for proposals for an organization that could take that funding and then leverage it in creating a much larger fund. And so we're announcing this morning, to my surprise, what I didn't know before was named the Doyenne Group Evergreen Fund. And there's a sheet of paper on your tables that explains a little bit more about it, and especially where all the money is coming from and going. And as you can see, as you look at that, the idea is to leverage funding from a lot of different organizations. And the city is part of that with the $600,000. And the Doyenne Group was selected as the fund manager. And what Doyenne is doing is putting together funding from all these different organizations that will be distributed in the forms of grants, loans, equity investment, and in programming that will support entrepreneurship and especially support closing the gender gap in entrepreneurship, and especially the gender gap that's huge in tech entrepreneurship. And so Heather is, I think, going to talk a little bit more about how it's all going to work and the timeline of when this funding will actually be available. But I'm thrilled that it's actually getting out on the street and that we can make some progress on this issue for us. So thank you all very much.
So we are going to start, you'll have to keep tuned in. We are going to start making grants. We'll do some by the end of the year, and then we'll start full force in 2017. So we invite all of you women entrepreneurs to engage with us, and with the funding will come a ton of support. So not only do you get dollars from Doyenne, you get an entryway into the ecosystem, and you get mentoring, and you get coaching, and you get developmental opportunities and connections to other money. So we are super excited about this, and we look forward to engaging with you. If you want to tell everyone you know, if you're not a woman entrepreneur, go find some and send them our way, because you'll enjoy it. And I think that's it for talking about this right now.
Yeah, I also just want to mention, when we first started doing the 5x5x5 3 years ago, the whole reason why we started doing this event was to try and gain momentum around this fund. And so we're really excited to now be at a point where we're actually launching it to be able to do grants, loans, who are partnering with WIBIC. I saw Julanne in the room, so if you would like to talk more about WIBIC, please talk to Julanne, as well as some angel investing within our community to help women leverage that dollars to put more into successfully growing their businesses, but then also supporting our local economy as well.
So one thing I want to say, just to clarify what the evergreen part of that means, that any returns that come, the grants are grants, but the spirit of it is a pay it forward model. So if you are getting traction and you are being profitable and you are being successful, the expectation is that you give something back so that we can send it back out. Any returns that we get from the loans and from the equity investments don't go to investors. They go right back into the fund to continually have money be recycled and sent back out. And that is what we mean by an evergreen fund. So we're hoping this has some longevity too.
Cool.
It's so pretty cool, right? Okay. Liz has something to say.
Oh, yes, Liz.
What kind of help does Doyenne need to land the fund?
We need more. We're going to talk about that later, Miss Liz. Liz is
Ms.
the chair.
Board chair. Thank you, Liz.
All right. So, as I mentioned, this is our third year. So, we would like to invite last year's grant recipient, Jody from Blue Diagnostics, to come up and speak about what's happened within the last year of running the business.
Thank you. Good morning. Last year, Katie Brenner gave the presentation, and winning Doyenne was really fantastic, positive momentum for us. We used our winnings. We had several questions around our regulatory strategy, our clinical trial, and how big that was going to be. And so winning the grant really helped us with momentum and also the dollars needed to answer some really important questions. I guess I should tell you what Blue Diagnostics is about. We are a diagnostic company, and we are aiming to develop a test that allows women to daily measure their key fertility hormones to help them in planning for fertility, but also really understanding their own cycle and their own body. So at this point, we closed a seed round in January, and now we're in full development. So again, I think winning last year was tremendous and really gave us a lot of positive momentum. So thank you.
Okay, so we're almost there. So before we get started on the pitches, I want to make sure we take a moment to thank and welcome our judges. So Sarah Justice from American Transmission Company, Adam Erdman from the Alliant Energy Foundation, Sabrina Madison from Hamas Progress, and Allison, I'm going to pronounce it wrong,
Helland,
from Murphy Desmond, and also the Latino Chamber of Commerce of Dane County. So thank you so much for coming this morning and judging our pitches. They are going to be judged on talking about what problem their business is solving, how they're doing it better than their competition, and then how are they going to leverage that $5,000 all within 5 minutes. So, I think we're ready to get started. Yeah, so that's the order of the businesses that are going to be going. And then let's have Florissette come up first.
Good morning. I'm Karen Harrington, co-founder of FloraSeq, and we are a company that is developing therapeutics for gastrointestinal diseases. So imagine you have a disease where living within the four walls of your bathroom is your reality. You are unable to spend time with family and friends, even hold down a job, because this disease results in debilitating diarrhea. It's embarrassing, it's shameful, and countless visits to the doctor and numerous rounds of antibiotics aren't helping. You feel as if your life is literally going down the toilet. Well, this disease is a result of Clostridium difficile, a bacteria, and the CDC has deemed it an urgent threat. It's the leading cause of hospital-acquired infection and results in more than 30,000 deaths each year here in the U.S. Now, you hear of this revolutionary new treatment, one that has a 90% success rate, one that within 48 hours allows you to go back to living that wonderful normal life you're used to. So what is this new treatment? Well, interestingly, it's poop, and fecal microbiota transplants are saving lives. So what is a fecal microbiota transplant, or FMT? Well, some of you may have heard of the microbiome. It's the study of the bacteria that are on us and in us. And in healthy individuals, our gut microbiome consists of thousands and thousands of good bacteria. And what FMT does is it's the process of taking those good bacteria from the stool and transplanting it into the gastrointestinal tract of a patient with C. diff. And what this does is it replenishes and repopulates the gut with that good bacteria and helps to outcompete the bad guys, like C. diff. Now, despite its great success at working and its acceptance in the medical community, FMT is actually not widely available to most patients. One of the reasons is sourcing donors. It's difficult to find donors that are qualified. In fact, it's often been said that it's easier to get into Harvard than it is to qualify to be a fecal transplant donor. One of the other limitations is the yuck factor for physicians and nursing staff having to prep the fecal material for transplantation. And the methods of transplantation are risky and invasive. It's currently being done by colonoscopy, NG tube, or enema. And so FloraSeq was really founded to find a better solution for both patients and physicians. And what we've been able to do is innovate FMT, putting it into a freeze-dried form that can be put into capsules and taken orally, a poop pill. What we've done is we have optimized methods to concentrate and preserve this essential bacteria, a lot like a probiotic. And we fully expect to have the same 90% success rate that you see with traditional FMT methods. In fact, right now we have a clinical study underway at the Medical College of Wisconsin to evaluate the effectiveness of our pills in patients with C. diff. Now, C. diff causes about 700,000 infections each year, and one in four, or just under 200,000 people, will develop a recurrent infection. And that's really our initial target market that we're going after. And this market is about $1 billion. We expect the cost of our dose to be around $3,000. Right now, it costs about $100 to make. And so once our drug is approved and on market, we would expect to see revenues grow to about $100 million or more. Now, there are currently no FDA-approved FMT-based therapies on market, and only a couple competitors that have their drugs in phase 2 clinical trials. One is the company Rebiotics. They have an enema-based drug, and we feel our oral pill solution is a much better solution than that. And the other is Seres Therapeutics. They have a stool-based drug, however, it contains a limited number of bacteria, and we, as well as other experts in the field, feel that a whole spectrum or whole stool approach is going to be more durable and effective at curing this infection. In fact, it's recently been published that the Seres drug has failed in its current FDA trial. Now, normally, it takes 10 years and $10 million to get a drug through the FDA. However, given the proven success of FMT and no reported serious adverse events, we're allowed to leapfrog straight into phase 2 clinical studies, saving years and millions of dollars. And we would expect that within 4 years, we could have our drug out there on the market. FloraSeq is co-founded by myself and business partner Steve Vissuri. We're both part of the management team of Prodessa, a local biotech startup that was acquired back in 2009. We're an experienced team with a proven track record of taking FDA-regulated products to market and startup success. So if we're lucky enough to win the Doyenne grant funding, we're planning on using that to purchase a freeze dryer, which is critical to our manufacturing process. And this would help us go into phase two studies and further the business. Right now, the instrument that we're using is just borrowed. So at FloraSeq, we give a shit about C. diff, and we hope you do too. Thank you.
I have like 2/10 of a second. That might be the best time for this.
Okay, that was 4:59.76. Nicely done.
All right, so while Kayla gets herself ready.
All right, we got to give our judges some time to process and tally score.
Go ahead.
So we wanted to tell you a little bit about what we do in Doyenne. We were founded in 2012, and we, over the last 4 years, have built, one of our key strategies is to build partnerships. We know that Doyenne can't accomplish everything, so that's just not how it's going to work, and change doesn't happen that way. So we're really a movement that engages 20 plus partners in our entrepreneurial ecosystem to create change. We have 125 members. Doyenne is a member organization, so we'd love to have you join us. We'll talk about that later. We do weekend, well, they're not weekend anymore, but 2.5-day retreats that are for women-owned businesses to do strategic planning, and we've had 35 businesses go through those retreats. We've had over 2,000 people attending all of our events, and we have 1,100 people who get emails from us. We try not to do it too often, but you hear from us, so you can get on our mailing list as well.
Okay. Judges, how you doing? I don't know why it keeps doing that. Okay. Are you guys ready for the next one?
All right. Okay, excellent.
So let's bring up Kayla.
Good morning, everybody. Turnover is defined as the move-in, move-out process of getting an apartment ready for the next renter. Turnover app is a first-to-market software application that automates this process for property managers, maintenance, painters, cleaners, carpet cleaners, and furniture movers, all on a mobile device. Think August 14th and 15th, when all of the students have nowhere to go and all the units need a lot of work in a little time. It's also known as Hippie Christmas, and it just happened last week here in Madison, Wisconsin, and across the country. Turnover happens in August and May when the students leave and return to school. It also happens at the end and the beginning of every month, and turnover is global. My name is Kayla Storlid, and I'm a co-founder of Turnover App. I'm also the owner of Kayla's Custom Cleaning. We created Turnover App to solve our turn tracking needs. Kayla's Custom Cleaning was founded in 2001. It generates over $1 million in revenues and has provided over 1,000 turn cleanings. Currently, the way that turnover is tracked is by spreadsheets, whiteboards, clipboards, signs on doors, forms, and text messaging. When we launched, we researched the market and we were unable to find any competitors. The way that it currently works is a property manager inspects the unit. Then they send a text message to the service provider or they post a sign on the door. The current method is slow, it's non-responsive, it creates pileup, and is unorganized. It's also been referred to as a war zone. The way that Turnover App solves this problem is that the property manager simply clicks that the unit has been checked out, selects which services need to be provided, and then the units will automatically release in order to the service provider. The service provider simply looks for the next green unit and clicks in and clicks out. Our customers will be property managers and service providers. Service providers include maintenance, painters, cleaners, carpet cleaners, and furniture movers. We'll charge property managers $10 per unit per turn or on a monthly subscription based on the number of units. We will charge vendors $5 per unit. The benefits include that it saves property managers and vendors time and money. It eliminates downtime, it reduces pileup, it allows for remote management, it tracks and calculates all of the vendors' time, it identifies vendor issues faster, and most importantly, it gets the next renter into the unit faster. My name is Kayla Storlid, and I'm in charge of business development, marketing, and sales. Jim is in charge of programming. Nationally, there are 222 million rental properties. The turn rate for student housing is 75%. Non-student housing is 55%. If we capture even 5% of the market at $5 per turn, we estimate the annual earning potential to be over $41 million. Turnover app is known on a national level by the biggest players in the student housing industry. I've attended several trade shows and met hundreds of property managers face to face. From those trade shows, I've collected trade journal magazines and I've connected to hundreds of property managers and vendors on LinkedIn. We have also been featured in trade journal magazines, podcasts, and speaking engagements. Turnover app was launched in January of 2016. At my last demo, when I got feature requests, I was able to say, it does that. We just completed our last beta test with over 40 users, 3 buildings, 400 units. The average sales cycle for property management software is 6 to 18 months. I project that once we secure 100 users, that turnover app will scale quickly. If we win the money, we will use it for companies like Pendo and Zendesk to create quick start guides, how-to videos, instructions in Spanish, and reminders to complete training. We'll use a company like Zendesk for inquiries, support, and service. Thank you for your consideration. Vote for Turnover App. Stop using spreadsheets and automate. Save time, money, and tears, and conquer the turnover war. Thank you.
You're way under. Okay. Thank you, Kayla. John, I see you in the back. You, yes. Okay, if you can't hear someone, next presenters, John, can you stand up? That guy back there is gonna do a dance. Let's see your dance. Okay, so he's gonna do that if he can't hear you. So that will help you. You have to keep the mic close to your mouth, though it feels weird.
All right, so on our last slide, we talked about how people engage with Doyenne. Here's a little bit more information. So Doyenne really focuses on 4 different pillars. One of the pillars is that community connection. The second one is increasing visibility through our events and our connections with the local media and other ways that we participate within the community. And the third pillar is the programming that we offer. So on the back of, I don't have one up here. On the back of that funding picture, thank you. On the bottom, it kind of lays out some of the programming that we offer. We really focus on networking, so how do we get more women engaged and showing up to different things in the community, but then also promoting their businesses, meeting other women entrepreneurs who are going through the same kind of successes and challenges that we face as an entrepreneur. And so we have our Doyenne Connect events, which are a great way to introduce you to Doyenne, but then also meet a lot of our members. Our Doyenne retreats that Amy talked about, they're strategic planning, 2-day workshops. I don't really want to call them conferences because it's a time for you to come work on your business instead of working in your business like we do on the day-to-day. And so those are really dedicated spaces where we sit down with the entrepreneurs who come and help them create a strategic plan to move their business forward. And then we also do CEO workshops where we target different areas within your business and we bring in mentors and experts to talk about how do you finance your business? How do you, as an entrepreneur, finance your business and also build your personal wealth, as well as how do you market your business and finding your target brand? So if you go to the website, it's doyennegroup.org and then /events, you can find all of our upcoming events for the rest of 2016. And I hope that many of you will show up. They're open to anyone to be able to attend, men and women. So I encourage you to come out and see what some of the other things that we work on during the year.
Judges.
All
right. We got thumbs up. Okay, excellent. And next, we have skate armor. Stephanie is up.
John? Okay, just checking. All right. Good morning. My name is Stephanie Mueller, and I'm representing Skate Armor and its founder, Terry Weiss. Now, you all live in Wisconsin. You're probably familiar with the game of ice hockey, correct? Well, over the years, hockey equipment has developed to become more protective. We've got better helmets, better mouth guards, better pads. But there is still one area of the body that is largely unprotected. The most life-threatening injury in hockey is a laceration to the neck. If a skate blade nicks that carotid artery, a player can bleed out in 1 to 2 minutes. Now, my friend and co-investor, Terry, has two kids who play that game, and she had seen enough to know that the neck protectors on the market just weren't cutting it. She knew she could do better. She found a cut-resistant, very flexible, very breathable fabric called SpectraGuard, manufactured by Honeywell Corporation in Minneapolis. She coupled it with a breathable wicking polyester cover and tabs that hold the neck protector right up where it needs to be, making it really effective. You can see here how much more effective it looks compared to our competitors at Bauer. But how do we know that it's more effective? Well, the folks at Mayo Clinic have proved it. In a study conducted by Mayo Clinic, they found that not only was Skate Armor the only neck protector that worked, it was the only one that didn't fail at least two-thirds of the time. And that's up against these household name competitors, Bauer, Easton, and Reebok. So we've got a great product. It's wearable, it's breathable, it's been proven effective, and it's patented in the US, Canada, and the European Union. But how does that translate into profits? Well, first let's take a look at the market. Now, there are over 500,000 registered youth hockey players in the US, but no one other than their parents is going to make them wear a neck protector. However, our neighbors to the north in Canada do require youth hockey players to wear those neck protectors, and there are over 700,000 of them. So that's where we're going first, Canada. In fact, in the next 3 years, once we get into that Canadian market, with very modest market share of 3% in year two and 6% in year three, we will find ourselves with $1.3 million in revenue at the end of that third year. Now, these numbers don't include the US market, the European market, or other products other than a goalie version of the Neckminder. We are just getting started with these numbers. I also want to point out the gross profit margin. For every neck protector we sell, we keep $20.69, or 65%. That's a really healthy gross margin, and that's what's going to enable us to be able to develop new products, get into new markets, and even new industries. But first, Canada. One of our most recent milestones was getting our Bureau de Naturalization de Quebec certification, or BNQ. Now, the Canadian government requires that all sports safety equipment be tested for reliability and quality. And after 16 months, we were finally awarded BNQ certification in April. This was a big deal. But we still need to do two key things before we can get into Canada. And that brings me to how we would use our grant money. First, our Canada patent expires in 5 years. Now, we've made some material and design modifications to the original model, so we can actually write a new patent, which would effectively renew that until 2026. Second, we need to revise our packaging to include that BNQ certification. It is literally a seal of approval that folks will be looking for when they're in Canada or in the US shopping for that, that neck protector. And if we have any other money left, we will use it for marketing. Now, I know that packaging and patents are not very exciting, but it's a very strategic thing for us to protect our profits in the future. Here's a little information about our team, but I really want to leave you with one important thought. $5,000 for skate armor would not be a drop in the bucket. On the contrary, it would be, after bootstrapping this company for several years, it would be the ping that sort of sets our dominoes in motion and gets us into that Canadian market. We appreciate your time and your consideration. Thank you.
I can take the clicker.
Okay, so we talked earlier that Doyenne is a membership organization that we have over 120 and growing number of members. Our members are entrepreneurs, but then we also have an ambassador network. So for people in the business community who are looking to support women entrepreneurs as they launch or scale their business, we encourage you to come on board as an ambassador. It's $100 a year to become a member of Doyenne Group.
It's a good $100 spent.
It's a good $100 spent. And then it's also been really cool to see what our members have accomplished within the last 4 years that we've been running the organization. So even at our table of presenters, we have two of them won Wisconsin Innovation Awards last week. Kayla won at Pressure Chamber last night. So they do amazing things, and it's really great to work with them and see them and the impact that they make within our community and the great things they're doing for everybody. So, do you want to add anything else? Okay.
Judges?
Good.
Okay, excellent. Next up, we have Angie Stone.
Good morning. My name is Angie Stone, and I'm the founder and CEO of High Life Oral Care Services. Helen lost 60% of her teeth in 2 years that she spent in the nursing home. As her granddaughter and a dental hygienist, I could not understand how this could happen. She's not alone. The Surgeon General reports that elderly residents have the worst oral health of any population. Oral health can lead to serious illness, including diabetes and aspiration pneumonia. Poor oral health also brings a huge financial burden. Aspiration pneumonia and diabetes in elders alone costs our Medicaid and Medicare system $3.5 billion annually. A simple 3% reduction in these two diseases could result in a savings of $544 million annually and save unnecessary suffering for over 12,000 elders. The decline of oral health begins when an elder can no longer take care of their own mouth and they become reliant on a nursing assistant to do that for them. Nursing assistants have a lack of education, they don't like caring for the mouth, and they don't have enough time. Our market is elders residing in skilled nursing facilities, residential care facilities, and those enrolled in adult daycare programs. This number is over 2.5 million people. This is also a global problem. The World Health Organization says that the oral health of older adults is a global problem, and they recommend countries find solutions. The two solutions that are happening in the United States currently are education of nursing assistants, and the research shows that this does not translate into an improved oral health of our elders. Those are also people who are providing actual dental services. They're focused on drilling, filling, and extracting teeth, and this does not address the cause. Remember, dentistry is only necessary when prevention fails. Our advantage is that we are the only complete disease prevention program in the United States, and we have our services delivered by experts. We bring certified oral care specialists, who are also registered dental hygienists, to the elder for weekly brushing and flossing. We control the bacteria between the visits with products containing xylitol. Our first milestone was when our first person had our protocol for 2 years and experienced no dental disease. We then opened up this protocol to a large group of elders and again proved our protocol works. It was published in a peer-reviewed medical journal in November of 2013. My book, Dying from Dirty Teeth, became an Amazon bestseller in April of 2015. We've had a consistent growth in oral care specialists and clients since our inception in 2013. Currently, we have 16 oral care specialists in 5 states serving 50 clients. Our service is $1,200 annually per client, so we have an annual revenue of $60,000. We split that 50% with the oral care specialists, bringing our current revenue, our per profit, to $30,000. In 1 year, we will have 25 oral care specialists seeing 250 clients with an annual revenue of $300,000 and annual profit of $150,000. By year 3, we expect to quadruple those numbers, and again, we'll quadruple the numbers by year 5, bringing us 400 oral care specialists serving at least 4,000 clients and an annual profit of $2.4 million. We do not have a shortage of people to achieve these goals. Our oral care specialists are dental hygienists, and their profession is saturated, and that's expected to increase. The baby boomers are going to give us enough elders to see because we have 40 million elders now, and that will be 72 million by the year 2030. We do, however, to get our client goal, need to shift our focus. Currently, we're going from family member to family member, which has been successful. However, that results in one client at a time. So we need to be able to engage the world of aging services where we can go kind of from the top down, get the facilities, have several residents being seen, and in a similar location. We need to refine our messaging so that we can reach this world of aging services. They speak a different language than we do, and we're learning all about that. So we would use the grant to transform our current print and electronic media messaging to engage the field of aging services. Thank you for considering helping High Life help our elders. And always remember, no one needs to die from dirty teeth.
Okay, so we wanted to share with you where the funds come from to support all the work Doyenne does. And I just want to mention how the work gets done. Heather and I are volunteer co-founders for the most part over the last 4 years, and Heather took on the executive director role as part of her full-time job. But we also have an army of people who help us. We have a fundraising committee. We have an events committee. We have a marketing and communications committee of people who dedicate their time to make this happen and on behalf of women entrepreneurs. So if everyone who is here who's on a Doyenne committee and on the Doyenne board, can you please stand up? I know I'm making you stand up, Liz. So Heather and I want to thank, and not everyone's in the room today, they couldn't be here, but we want to thank all of those people because that's what Doyenne is. It's Heather and me. It's all of those people who dedicate their time, and actually it's everyone in this room. So where do the dollars come from? We have corporate sponsors who are very dear to us and help make this work happen. So we want to thank our corporate sponsors. We also get donations. We have a Doyenne 1000 campaign. So we are looking for 100 people who will donate $1,000 a year to support the expansion of women's entrepreneurship. And we also get other donations that come in. And you will be able to make a contribution today after the event is over. So think about that. We have membership fees. As Heather said, it's $100 a year to become a member, which is actually pretty reasonable. As a member, we put your picture on our website. As a member entrepreneur, when we get a call that says we need someone to be on a panel, we go through our member list first. When we get a call that says we want to sponsor someone to attend a conference, we go through our member list first. When we get a call from Madison Magazine that says we want to highlight some women entrepreneurs, we go through our member list. So it is a great opportunity. Our monthly meetings, we highlight a member. so you get to talk to other people about your business and your experience. And we get fees from events, and we get grants. And grants have been a huge support of us and the Evergreen Fund. Anything you want to add to that? Okay, judges, we are ready. Okay. And our next presenter is Chorum.
Hi, everyone. My name is Chorum Pak. I'm the president and founder of Lynx Biosciences, or Lynx Bio for short. Currently, there are over 1.2 million people living with a blood cancer today. Unfortunately, every 9 minutes, someone passes away from this disease. And this is due to the fact that many blood cancers are currently incurable. So once patients relapse and become resistant to therapy, treatment is often a trial and error process. So it's not until we treat patients with, let's say, drug A, that we can determine which patients actually responded to drug A and which did not. Now imagine a scenario in which you can take a standard of care biopsy from a patient and use that to test different drugs on to predict which drugs will actually work for each patient. Lynx Bio is developing technologies to enable that exact scenario to predict clinical treatment response for blood cancer patients. Our technology is called MicroCube. It tests the therapeutic response of patients' own tumor cells with their own non-tumor cells. What this allows us to do is create a little model of someone's own cancer outside of their body. We then use that to test different drugs on, rather than using the patient as a guinea pig. This is our device shown here. It's a miniaturized microfluidic device that allows us to perform this test for every patient. This is a technological advance compared to other companion diagnostics that cannot oftentimes be performed for all patients. We would be about a $5,000 test compared to a potentially ineffective therapy costing $100,000 or more. Furthermore, we're an incredibly rapid test. We can have results within 3 days of that standard of care biopsy, allowing us to seamlessly integrate into the clinical workflow. Our early retrospective studies correctly identified all patients as either clinically responsive or non-responsive to a very common blood cancer drug. While this is a small cohort of patients, we are very excited because this is a striking correlation compared to other assays similar to ours that only got about a 30 to 60% accuracy rate. In terms of IP, we have 2 patents pending, owned outright. So for our major milestones, our retrospective studies allowed us to begin our current prospective clinical trial that is currently enrolling patients. The results of this trial will help inform the size and design of our next pivotal clinical trial due to begin second quarter of 2017. Our prospective studies will also validate our technology, allowing us to establish strategic partnerships with different pharmaceutical companies to further develop our technology as new companion diagnostics to other blood cancer therapies. We're very unique in the sense that we can be developed as a companion diagnostic to any blood cancer therapy. We're not tied to a single biomarker like many other tests are. We aim to achieve FDA approval and sales by the end of 2019. For our markets, we fall under the precision medicine market due to reach $88 billion globally by 2022. Within that, we fall under the companion diagnostics market due to reach $5.6 billion by 2020. We are beginning with multiple myeloma as a model cancer and are therefore developing companion diagnostics to different myeloma therapies and are tied to the myeloma drug market due to reach $22.4 billion by 2023. At this moment, I'd like to mention that while there are many companion diagnostics available for solid cancer therapies, there are very few for blood cancers and none for multiple myeloma. And there are currently no other companies out there that can replicate our technology. Our team is shown here. I'm the president and founder. This technology spun out of my PhD graduate work at the UW a few years ago. We have 2 scientific advisors, Professor Dave Beebe and Professor Edmund Young, both of whom are pioneers in the field of microfluidics. Our lead engineer is now Dr. Teddy DeGroot. He has over 6 years of experience with microfluidic device development and GMP regulatory compliant manufacturing. We do realize we are in need of some business development and regulatory expertise, so we are hiring to fill those voids. For our financing, we are currently supported by a phase one SPR through early 2017. The $5,000 would really help us to hire that regulatory consultant that we really desperately need to design our next pivotal clinical trial. We're currently seeking also a seed funding round to get us to the end of 2017. We aim to be cash positive by 2020 with 1,600 units sold, doubling each year thereafter, with an operating profit of $3.7 million climbing to $21 million in 2022. For our exit strategy, we can be acquired by different diagnostics companies such as Roche or Abbott or Exact Sciences, or by pharmaceutical companies such as Takeda or Amgen. As we grow our repertoire of companion diagnostics and increase our portfolio, there is a possibility for an IPO in later stages. So with that, thank you, and we're Lynx Bio.
Okay, so judges, if you, that was the last one, right? Okay. if you would like to go out in the hallway and discuss, we can show you, there's an area where you guys can talk about while they're tabulating who the grant winner is this morning. I wanted to invite Rachel to come back up and talk a little bit more about 1 Million Cups.
Hi, everyone. I'm really excited to be here today. I'm super passionate about female entrepreneurs and kind of growing this segment here in Madison. So I was very excited to partner with the Doyenne Group. I'm sure a lot of you have heard about 1 Million Cups. I see some of our past presenters in the audience and definitely some audience members, but I'd love to give you an overview. And we have some of my team members here today, Drew Corson and Leah Anderson. Do you guys want to stand up? So myself, Drew, Leah, and Shobin work together on a volunteer basis, and every Wednesday morning here at Madison Central Library, we have a business or young entrepreneur come in and pitch their business. And the great thing is that we're really trying to blend community with the startup scene here. So there's a lot that's happening in Madison in between co-working spaces and different entrepreneurial events, but it's hard to get plugged into that if you're not necessarily an entrepreneur or you're not in that inner circle. And what we're looking to do is bring more diversity into the scene. So our weekly meetup is free. We have great coffee from Crescendo that's provided via our sponsors, which for the past 6 months has been 100 state. Claudia's over there representing them. And it's a chance you can walk in off the street if you want. You can invite a friend. You don't have to have any kind of special business background. And you get to contribute and really hear what's happening in your city. So each week when the presenter gets up, they do a 15-minute presentation. And then the audience gets another 15 minutes to provide feedback and act sort of like a very kind Midwestern Shark Tank. So, and we get some really great exposure for the companies as well. So Field 59 does the live stream and the video recording. So if you're an entrepreneur, you get to take that along with you. And you can use that for whatever you see fit, whether it's advertising or sharing with friends and family. And then we have Eric in the back there from the Cap Times, who will come out sometimes and write a article on our startups, which we're really appreciative of, because then we get even more word out about what's happening. And I think aside from the diversity and getting more women exposed into the startup scene, we really want to make this city a place where talent can thrive. And when these businesses get out there and they're able to get established and get some recognition, we create jobs, we boost our economy. There's just a whole range of things that happen that are really good for our city and everyone here. So I would encourage you, if you haven't checked out 1 Million Cups, to come visit us. You can stop by 9 a.m. The library doors open and we're right upstairs here. So feel free to invite your friends. Or if you're a company or know somebody who's looking to pitch, please come to visit our website and apply. It's a really easy process, and we will get you scheduled and also offer our services as mentors. So I specialize in operations, staffing. I work currently for Nordic, and I've been with them since we were fairly small. We're now at over 800 employees, so I bring some experience in that space. And then we have Drew, who's a startup attorney, who's happy always happy to chat. We have Leah, who specializes in marketing, social media, and staffing, so she's a great resource. And then Chobin Thacker, who works for HealthX Ventures and is a VC. So between us, we'd be happy to donate our time and review your pitch deck and help make connections for you. All right, thank you so much.
Okay, while we're waiting for the judges to deliberate, we also wanted to mention some upcoming events that we have for Doyenne. We have our annual golf outing coming up on September 21st. And even if you've never golfed before, please come. We're going to be having practice with a pro before the golf outing, where they will kind of run you through how playing at a golf event works, practice your swing, practice your putt, but then also we'll have another little workshop where how to network on the golf course. We hear that a lot of business deals get done on the golf course. And so knowing how to work 18 holes to meet the right people and be able to promote yourself will be something else that we will be helping or working with the people that attend the golf outing. So register your foursome today. Registration is open until Friday, September 16th. It's $150 per individual, with $50 of that going towards supporting Doyenne right into our Evergreen Fund to help make more grants, loans, and equity investments possible. And we hope to see you all there.
What's next? Okay, you have work to do. You thought you were just sitting there quietly listening, but you have work to do. First of all, if you want to become a member, please do. You can do that today. If you're an entrepreneur, you can become a member. And if you want to be an ambassador, if you have talent and time you're willing to spend, everyone in here has a skill set, and want to contribute that, become an ambassador and we can make connections for you. And if you want to learn more about it, you can talk to Heather or me.
And there's Chandra out at the registration table, has the computer set up so you can fill out the membership form right now, and we'll get you listed on the website by the end of today as a new member.
Make a contribution today. We talked about the fund that we're building. That fund is only possible if one component of that is private contributions from all of you. We use that to use matching money from the state, matching money from the city. So you can also do that today with Chandra. She is the go-to person in the hallway, Chandra. Attend our next Connect meeting, and those are, we highlight one of our members, and they're super fun. It's very low-key. It's an easy entry point to engage Doyenne. Our next one is September 14th. You can get more information and register for that on our site. We have our October retreat is coming up. And again, that's strategic planning. It is not a conference. You have to work. You come with your laptop, with your pens. We bring the pens. You don't even actually. Post-its, flip charts. You work hard. But it gets you. Yeah, I know. You work hard every day, but then you have to come here and work hard. But what happens is, and most of you have run a business know, you get bogged down in the day-to-day. And you know you need to do strategic planning, but you can't figure out how to fill out the time, set aside the time to do it. But this is what we do. We bring the food, we bring the markers, we bring the flip charts, we bring the mentors, we put you in a lovely space at Hotel Red, and you get a lot done. We say, what does the business need to look like in 5 years? How can we help you get there? And when you leave in 2.5 days, you have a to-do list to do, so that when you go back to regular life, how many have gone to a conference and you think you have brilliant ideas, and then you go back to regular life and the brilliant ideas go in the drawer and you go back to doing the same thing? How many? Raise your hand. Yeah, well, and those who aren't raising their hand, I don't believe you. So sign up. It is limited space. Our absolute max is 10 entrepreneurs. The entrepreneur can come and she can bring her team. If you are a solo entrepreneur, you can bring a mentor or a peer or someone that's important in your life that has helped you grow your business, so you have someone, a team member there. You can just come yourself. So I encourage you to register. There are some people in the room who have been through this experience. They can talk to you about it. It is really transformative. And then, as Heather said, come play golf. You don't have to know how. You have to pick up the club, swing it, and walk, and drink, and laugh, and I'm going to come around with a camera, and I'm going to make him do ridiculous poses, and we're going to have a contest who does the craziest pose. Okay? Does that sound fun? Woo! Woo! I got one woo! Yes. I'll take any woo I can get. Y'all are heavy in here. Lighten up. Okay. Do we have anything else?
I don't think so.
I think
so,
our judges are still talking.
Still delivering. I want to emphasize, you know, Doyenne is focused on women entrepreneur, but we're also really just inclusive entrepreneurship. So when we first started working with the Forward Fest 4 years ago, I think the average woman attendance at events was less than 10%. And since then, we're up to about 40% is the average female-male participation. Which has been awesome. We've also seen a lot of gains within our state. So when we first started Doyenne, Wisconsin was ranked dead last for women entrepreneurship within our country. Since the new numbers this year, we're up to 38, which is also like, oh, we're 38? But we went up like 12 spots. That's awesome. So we really do believe that Madison is a hub for all entrepreneurship, but we want to really make this a hub for women entrepreneurship and really raise the bar as to what we can do within our community, how we can support each other, and really make a difference and get Wisconsin and get Madison ranked within the top 10 of the nation.
And you cannot be a startup city if not everybody's engaging in the startup process. I like that too. You're catching on. If only one segment gets to be an entrepreneur and gets to be talked about as an entrepreneur, that's a city with a scene. It's not a startup city. So that's what we're on a mission to do, is get more women involved, more people of color involved, and make this really a startup city and really put Wisconsin out there. So, but it doesn't happen. It's a movement that has to have everybody doing their part, and everybody has something to give. So figure out what you have to give, and join us in the movement. And the judges are still, yes, Liz, can I bring you the mic? Why don't you come up since you have something to say, Liz? Come. She should come up, right, guys? Liz is awesome. She has been with us from the beginning.
Thanks.
We love you.
Hi. Thank you all for coming. I have been involved with Doyenne since the beginning. I think I met 4 years ago. These ladies have done tremendous work. I think when we had this event, there may have been like three tables over there. So the growth has been tremendous. But I really want to emphasize the fund, because this has been like such a major accomplishment for this organization. And your contribution today, if you give a dollar, that means $6 goes into the Doyenne fund. And that comes from matching from $3 from the city, a dollar from Wedick, and a dollar from Wibick. Thank you, Julianne. So if you give a dollar today, $6 goes into the Doyenne Fund. And you just don't see that kind of multiplier to your contribution really anywhere else. Right, Katie?
Right.
Thank you. Ever, right? And that is a $1.2 million fund, which far exceeds our expectations of what we set out to do when we established the fund. We thought we were going to have a $300,000 or $400,000 fund. So now, with all the matching and the support from the community, we can get a $1.2 million fund. There's a really big chunk of that that goes to all the programming that the ladies have been talking about today to make an impact into the ecosystem, and then to make the contributions and the grants and the loans for startup companies, let alone all of the network here, the support services from Nider and Boucher and Fine Point Consulting and all the services that these companies need. So Doyenne has really come and matured a lot in the last, right, Val, in the last 3 years. We have the funding, we have the services, we have the support of the community, so we're asking all of you to help and participate and contribute to the fund so we can land this in the community. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you, Liz. Thank you, Liz.
Okay, before we bring the judges up, I just want to again say thank you to our sponsors for today. Today wouldn't be possible without you guys. Also, thank you to the library for graciously providing the space for us to be able to have this event. Thank you to Crescendo for donating the coffee for today, and thank you to Field 59 for coming out and live streaming and recording the event for us.
And I just want to say all five presenters kicked butt today, didn't they? This is a group of amazing women, and I cannot wait to see where they go with these businesses. One of the things Heather and I love about this work is we get to be along. We have the privilege and the gift to be along on the journey with all of you. So we thank you for being who you are, for doing the work you do, and for being part of this Doyenne event. So thank you.
All right.
We have a spokesperson.
Okay, come on, judges.
Okay. Well, I really want to say to all the presenters, fabulous job. You made our job incredibly hard. We really think all of you are worthy and would love to be able to support every one of your businesses. I think you're all going to have a very bright future. But our very tough decision for the award this year goes to Lynx Bio.
It was a wonderful experience working with these group of women with this competition. This was a very, this was wonderful. I got to meet all of you guys, and honestly, you guys all did great. You did such great presentations, and you have such great business ideas. And so best of luck to you guys. I'm sure I'm not supposed to do an Oscar-style speech, but I want to thank my other team members who aren't here, but a few of them, my advisors in particular, are I worked in collaboration with them for 8 years now, so they have really been through me and this business for a long time and have just gone through everything. Like, it took us 4 years to get an actual prototype, so they're not here, but they're awesome people. So if you ever see them, say hi. All right. Thank you, guys.
Okay. So thank you, everybody, for coming out this morning. I'm sure there's more food, so please feel free to grab more food, more coffee. Chandra's out at the registration table. Please consider signing up to become a member or an ambassador or making a contribution to the organization. And I hope to see you all in September at our golf outing. Enjoy the rest of Forward Fest.